Listening Library presents Revolution, the 60s Trilogy by Deborah Wiles. Read for you by Stacey Aswad, Francois Battiste, J.D. Jackson, Robin Miles, and a full cast.
I too sing, America. I am the darker brother. They send me to eat in the kitchen when company comes, but I laugh and eat well and grow strong. Tomorrow, I'll be at the table when company comes. Nobody'll dare say to me, eat in the kitchen, then. Besides, they'll see how beautiful I am and be ashamed. I too am America. Langston Hughes, 1932.
A great change is at hand, and our task, our obligation, is to make that revolution, that change, peaceful and constructive for all. Those who do nothing are inviting shame, as well as violence. Those who act boldly are recognizing right, as well as reality.
John F. Kennedy, President of the United States, announcing that a civil rights bill will be sent to Congress June 11, 1963.
We do not accept Jews because they reject Christ, and through the machinations of their international banking cartel, are at the root center of what we call communism today. We do not accept papists because they bow to a Roman dictator in direct violation of the First Commandment and the true American spirit of responsible individual liberty. We do not accept Turks, Mongols, Tartars, Orientals, Negroes, nor any other person whose native background of culture is foreign to the Anglo-Saxon system of government by responsible, free individual citizens.
From Why You Should Join the Ku Klux Klan, 1964.
With this faith, we will be able to hew out of the mountain of despair a stone of hope. With this faith, we will be able to transform the jangling discords of our nation into a beautiful symphony of brotherhood. With this faith, we will be able to work together, to pray together, to struggle together, to go to jail together, to stand up for freedom together, knowing that we will be free one day.
Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. at the March on Washington for Jobs and Freedom, Washington, D.C., August 28, 1963.
A revolution is bloody. Revolution is hostile. Revolution knows no compromise. Revolution overturns and destroys everything that gets in its way. And you sitting around here like a knot on the wall saying, I'm gonna love these folks no matter how much they hate me? No, you need a revolution. Who ever heard of a revolution where they lock arms singing, we shall overcome? Just tell me. You don't do that in a revolution. You don't do any singing. You're too busy swinging.
Malcolm X from his speech, Message to the Grassroots, November 1963.
Part 1. Encampment.
I may never march in the infantry, ride in the cavalry, shoot the artillery. I may never fly or the enemy, but I'm in the Lord's army.
Ain't gonna let nobody turn me around, turn me around. Turn me around, ain't gonna let nobody turn me around. Gonna keep on walking, keep on talking, marching up to freedom land. Wake up, America. Wake up, for we cannot stop and we will not be patient.
The Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee, SNCC Chairman, John Lewis, ends his speech at the March on Washington for Jobs and Freedom, August 28, 1963.
All persons born or naturalized in the United States and subject to the jurisdiction thereof are citizens of the United States and of the state wherein they reside. No state shall make or enforce any law which shall abridge the privileges or immunities of citizens of the United States, nor shall any state deprive any person of life, liberty, or property without due process of law, nor deny to any person within its jurisdiction the equal protection of the laws.
Section 1, the Citizenship Clause of the 14th Amendment to the U.S. Constitution, July 9, 1868, which overruled Dred Scott versus Sanford, 1857, which held that slaves and their descendants were not protected by the Constitution and were not U.S. citizens.
Welcome to the 1964 World's Fair in beautiful Flushing Meadows Park, New York.
The 12 stories tall Unisphere represents our growing global interdependence. The three rings around it symbolize the orbit tracks of three satellites that have circled our globe. Yuri Gagarin, the first man in space, John Glenn, the first American to orbit the Earth, and Telstar, the first active communication satellite.
See you at the fair, where the theme is peace through understanding.
Ain't gonna let injustice turn me around.
This administration today, here and now, declares unconditional war on poverty in America. I urge this Congress and all Americans to join with me in that effort.
From U.S. President Lyndon Baines Johnson's State of the Union Address, January 8, 1964.
This is your freedom summer. It will not work without your help. COFO is asking you to provide housing for the people who are coming to work here. Look for buildings which can be used for freedom schools and community centers. Get names of students who want to go to freedom schools. Let us know when you have meetings or arrange meetings so we can come answer questions about the Freedom Summer.
From the Council of Federated Organizations, COFO, brochure distributed to black citizens across Mississippi, 1964.
Many people are coming here to work during our Freedom Summer. They want to learn about Mississippi. They feel that the problems here are the problems of people all over the country. Most of them will be college students, both Negro and white.
COFO Brochure, 1964.
Ain't gonna let segregation turn me around.
The white race deems itself to be the dominant race in this country. But in view of the Constitution, in the eye of the law, there is in this country no superior, dominant ruling class of citizens. Our Constitution is colorblind. In respect of civil rights, all citizens are equal before the law.
U.S. Supreme Court Associate Justice John Marshall Harlan, writing the single dissenting vote against Plessy versus Ferguson, 1896, which created a separate but equal society, overturned civil rights gains from Reconstruction, including the Civil Rights Act of 1866, and undermined 1868's 14th Amendment to the U.S. Constitution.
Brooklyn, New York, 1963. In a corps-sponsored protest, protesters are removed from a construction site.
If we don't work, nobody works!
Hundreds were arrested, including 17 children.
We conclude that, in the field of public education, the doctrine of separate but equal has no place. Separate educational facilities are inherently unequal.
U.S. Chief Justice Earl Warren, writing for the court, Brown v. Board of Education, which overturned Plessy v. Ferguson in 1954.
Less than 7% of Mississippi's voting-age Negroes are registered. This summer, a concentrated vote drive will be held as part of the Mississippi Summer Project.
From the Student Voice, the newspaper of SNCC, June 9, 1964.
I want you
in the White Knights of Mississippi, Ku Klux Klan.
There is no state with a record that approaches that of Mississippi in inhumanity, murder, brutality, and racial hatred. It is absolutely at the bottom of the list.
Roy Wilkins, chairman of the NAACP.
Ain't gonna let Mississippi turn me around.
Either you believe in states' rights, home rule, or you believe in turning over this state to a black minority.
Paul Johnson, governor of Mississippi on the campaign trail, 1963.
The second trial of Byron Della Beckwith ended in a mistrial today. Beckwith of Greenwood, Mississippi, was accused of the murder of civil rights leader Medgar Evers in Jackson, Mississippi, in June 1963. Beckwith has been released from police custody and has returned home to Greenwood.
Crosses were burned on April 24, 1964, in 64 of Mississippi's 82 counties to protest the coming summer invasion of Mississippi. To prepare, Mayor Allen Thompson hired 100 extra police officers, purchased 250 extra shotguns, and a 13,000-pound armored personnel carrier with a submachine gun mounted on the turret. The Mississippi legislature passed a bill to restrain movements of individuals under certain circumstances.
Today, Americans of all races stand side by side in Berlin and in Vietnam. They died side by side in Korea. Surely they can work and eat and travel side by side in their own country.
U.S. President Lyndon Baines Johnson, State of the Union Address, January 8, 1964.
I'm going to Mississippi this summer to teach in the freedom schools. I want to help in whatever way I can to alleviate injustice and to help people develop self-esteem and dignity. I want to learn from people who have known more grief, humiliation, and misery than I can ever know.
Pam Parker to members of her church, Trinity Episcopal, Solbury, Pennsylvania, June 9, 1964.
It seems almost incomprehensible at this moment that in 2 days the world of all of us here will change so drastically. If ugly things happen to us, if death comes to us, it will be in such a way, for the same reasons that they have happened to untold numbers of Negroes for years.
From summer volunteer Zoya Zeman's diary, June 24th, 1964.
Ain't gonna let no jailhouse turn me around.
Self-defense in Mississippi. If you are attacked, roll up in a knot and hit the ground. Stay as close to your knees as possible, legs together, because a leg sticking out can be broken with one quick step. Don't carry watches, pens, glasses, and never more than $5 to $10. If you're caught from behind, go limp. Watch for cars without license plates and cops without badges. Never be the last to leave a meeting. Never leave alone.
George Harrison, what do you call that hairstyle you're wearing?
Arthur.
Ain't gonna let no hatred turn me around.
There are now 16,300 American military advisors in South Vietnam. South Vietnam received $500 million in U.S. aid during 1963.
We must be strong enough to win any war, and we must be wise enough to prevent one. We shall neither act as aggressors nor tolerate acts of aggression. We intend to bury no one, and we do not intend to be buried. We can fight if we must, as we have fought before. But we pray that we will never have to fight again.
U.S. President Lyndon Baines Johnson, State of the Union Address, January 8, 1964.
All our dreams can come true if we have the courage to pursue them.
Walt Disney.
If we were all voting, then things would be better in Mississippi.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.